on this 40th avatar day, entering into 40th year, my commitment to Sadashiva and to all of you, with all my integrity, whatever Sadashiva has done to me, I'll share with all of you and make sure it is reproduced on at least few million people. And we create the new species, new beings, radiating Sadashivatva. Radiating Sadashivatva. So today my message is, Sanatana Hindu Dharma is real. The Mahavagya I wanted to offer to all of you, Sadashivoham. And the whole science and applied technology, Sadashiva expressed in four Vedas, Rig, Sama, Yajur, Adarvana, and the Agamas, Karana, Kamika, and all other Agamas and Upagamas. Using this whole technology, reviving everything, oh humanity, I commit with you. With all my integrity to Sadashiva, I commit with you. I will make new species. Sadashiva has empowered me with whatever is needed to do that job, and I will not withdraw. I will not back off. I will not bother about the detractors. I will let them have their stuff. See, all the detractors, I am wearing new gold crown. Talk about it today. Because anyhow, you are neither interested nor find out what is going on inside my head. So at least talk about what I am wearing outside my head. Enjoy. You be busy with your job. Let me be busy with my job. And humanity, I commit with you guys. It is my integrity to Sadashiva. Whatever he has done to me, I should share with you all, and I'll do it. I am neither humble nor arrogant. I am straight. I am neither humble nor arrogant. I am very straight. Humbleness can be a very powerful way to hide our arrogance. I am neither humble nor arrogant. I am very straight. Sadashiva has done something to me, and it has made me a new being. I'll do the same to you all. I'll share with you all the same. I'll reproduce the same with you all and make the same new beings in you all. I also commit with you, with all my integrity, whatever stands the acid wash scrutiny of Shastra Pramana, means Vedas and Agamas directly. And Apta Pramana, the great rishis, their words like Patanjali, Sri Krishna, Rama, the great incarnations of Sanatana Hindu Dharma, all their words I call Apta Pramana. Whatever stands the scrutiny and acid wash of Shastra Pramana and Apta Pramana, only that with the clear reference of Shastra Pramana and Apta Pramana only, I'll share it with you all and make that as your Sakshi Pramana. Whatever is my Atma Pramana, my experience given to me by Sadashiva, I'll scrutinize, acid wash everything with Shastra Pramana and Apta Pramana. Whatever stands this acid test, only that I'll be offering it to all of you and making it as Sakshi Pramana. And it's my clear commitment to all of you. I think this is my message to all of you. This is my message on this 40th Avatar Day. Yesterday I was asking one of my disciples, 39 years over, entering into 40th year, did I do enough what I need to do? Maybe, instead of judging whether I did or not, in my scale or in somebody else's scale, I decided I'll do it much beyond any expectation or any possibility from this year. Just how we made the Gurukul completely free from last Vijayadashami, I am also making few more programs, especially making kids below 18 manifesting powers sessions and classes and programs for them completely free. At various levels, 10 day, 15 day, 21 day, 3 months. Not only the kids from India, even the college going kids in US, other countries, NRIs. Kids in US, they have to do some projects during their graduation. They can come, learn these powers in 3 months and go back. They will also get a lot of credit. We will certify through our Nityananda University. And already we published yoga exactly from the Shastra Pramana and Apta Pramana to remove all the wrong ideas. There's so many stupid brands, Jik Yoga, Chak Yoga, Chuk Yoga, and Cross Yoga, and I don't know what all the names. One, the dilution. Another one, to warn these fellows who go and talk all over the world, yoga has nothing to do with Hinduism. Understand, we are ready to offer the fruits to the whole world. But yoga is rooted in Hinduism. As Mahamandaleshwar of Mahanirvani Peetha, representative of the Hinduism, I throw open challenge. The people who go around and talk, there are cultural frills in Hinduism. Come on, I am calling you for an open debate. Tell me, what is cultural frill? I'll establish there is no cultural frill in Hinduism. There is no cultural frills in Hinduism. There is no cultural frills in Hinduism. I am making it very clear. Anybody who says there is a cultural frills in Hinduism, be very clear. You are talking about something forced on us by the non-Hindus. And we were made to believe something which is not Hinduism as Hinduism. You may be talking about that. Then better be very clear. Things forced on Hinduism, use the right word. Don't use the word cultural frills. Sometimes in the achara, non-Hindus have diluted us. Anushtana vidhis are clear, available in shastras. Incarnations come down to make the achara into anushtana, in tune with anushtana. Understand? Anushtana means the vidhis, written in Vedas and Agamas. Achara means during the practice, the non-Hindus enter and dilute. And that is not cultural frills by us. Let me make it very clear. If you are sincere, even if you find some one or two acharas going little this way, that way, take the effort to bring the achara back to anushtana. That is the real work need to be done. Not that you will go around and tell everyone, come into my house, there is a fight going on between me and my daughter, me and my wife, me and my son, occupy the house. No cultural frills in Hinduism. Anybody can challenge. I am ready for a debate. The condition is, if you prove something is cultural frill, I'll become your disciple. If I prove there is no cultural frill, you become my disciple. That is what happened between Shankara and Mandana Mishra. We Hindus believe in debates. Very spiritually enriching, strengthening researches. I tell you, Hindu tradition is the most pure tradition. Even if our acharyas have differences of opinion, they never touch the original verse. The Mula Sutras, the original verses are so pure, chaste, untouched, just because of our integrity of our acharyas. No tradition can boast this purity. I wanted to tell everyone who says Hinduism is cultural frill, see your next generation, what will happen to you? Only one generation is enough. What will happen to you and your organization? Our Hindu masters were so integrated. Ramanuja, Shankara and Madhva, they had complete different views, different ideas, different way of explaining. They have done completely different commentaries on Prasthanatraya, but nobody dared to touch a single letter of the original sutra. See their integrity. Looking at this tradition and religion, you dare to say cultural frills? I want you to tell the whole world, Sanatana Hindu Dharma is real. Don't worry, there is no cultural frill. Achara and Anushtana both are in its best form in this tradition. Welcome, come, enjoy, become a new species. I am declaring, my life's mission is to make people understand Agama, lifestyle is not cultural frills. Lifestyle, Agamas, every small things, even singing and jumping and dancing, even all those are the powerful methodology for Shakti Nipata, spiritual entanglement. So, I am committed to the humanity to make new species as per the blessings and whatever Sadashiva shared and made it happen in this being. And I invite the whole universe, come, enjoy, experience, live, express, radiate, Sadashivoham. 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 Sadashivoham.